Hey everyone, Steve Patterson here again from PhotoshopEssentials.com. In this video, I'll show you how to create a simple spray paint text effect where the letters look like they've been spray painted onto a wall or a background. I'll also show you how to blend the spray paint in with the background for a more realistic looking effect. And since we'll be creating the spray paint using nothing more than a layer effect and Photoshop's blending options, your text will remain editable even when we're done. I'm using Photoshop CC, but any recent version will work. If you like these videos, be sure to subscribe and let's get started. We'll start by learning how to create the main spray paint effect, and then I'll show you how to blend the letters in with the background. I'll also show you how to duplicate the effect to add more text to your design and how to change the color of the paint. Start by opening your background image. I'll use this image that I downloaded from Adobe Stock. The first thing we'll do is add some text. Select the Type tool from the toolbar, and then in the Options bar, choose your font. I'm using HWT Gothic Round, which I downloaded from Adobe Typekit. If you don't have access to this font, that's okay. Any font will work. Set your type size to 72 points, just to give us the largest preset size for now. And still in the Options bar, I'll set my text alignment to center. For the color of the text, I'll choose white by clicking on the color swatch and choosing white from the color picker. Now this is not the color we're going to use for the spray paint. All we need for now is something that lets us see the text as we're adding it. Then click in the document and add your text. I'll type the word paint. To accept it, click the check mark in the options bar. To resize the text and move it into place, go up to the edit menu in the menu bar and choose free transform. And then to resize the text, click and drag any of the corner handles. As of Photoshop CC 2019, the aspect ratio is automatically locked as you drag the handles. But if you're using an earlier version of Photoshop, you'll need to hold down your Shift key as you drag to lock the aspect ratio in place. To resize the text from its center, press and hold your Alt key or the Option key on a Mac as you drag. And to reposition your text, click inside the Free Transform box and drag it into place. I'll make my text just a bit bigger, and then I'll make sure it's centered in front of the background. To accept your changes, click the check mark in the Options bar. In the Layers panel, we see our text on a new type layer above the image. To create the spray paint effect, we need to make our text transparent, and there's two ways to do that. One is by using the Opacity option, and the other is by using Fill. Now at first, Opacity and Fill may seem like they do the same thing. If I lower the opacity value all the way down to 0%, the text becomes completely transparent. I'll raise the opacity back to 100%. And then, if I lower the Fill value down to 0%, again the text disappears. So what's the difference between opacity and fill? The difference is that opacity controls the appearance of both the contents of a layer and any layer effects we've applied. Layer effects are things like stroke, drop shadow, outer glow, and so on. But fill affects the appearance of just the layer's contents. It has no effect on the layer effects. So by lowering the fill value, we can make the text transparent and still keep our layer effects visible. Now we haven't added any layer effects yet, but we will in a moment. For now, lower the fill value all the way down to zero. The entire spray paint effect can be created using a single layer effect, and the one we need is drop shadow. With your type layer selected, click on the Layer Styles icon or the Effects icon at the bottom of the Layers panel and choose Drop Shadow from the list. In the Layer Style dialog box, start by clicking the Reset to Default button to restore the default drop shadow settings. Then change the drop shadow's color by clicking the color swatch. In the color picker, choose white for now, and then click OK. We'll choose different colors for the effect once we've added all of our text. To see the white, change the blend mode of the drop shadow from Multiply to Screen. And now we see a thin white shadow behind the letters. To make the effect brighter, increase the opacity of the drop shadow all the way to 100%. By changing the color of the drop shadow from black to white and changing its blend mode from multiply to screen, we've turned our shadow into a glow. You can ignore the angle option since the direction of the light source won't matter, but lower the distance to 0 pixels. This centers the drop shadow behind the text, creating an outline or stroke around the letters. Also, make sure that the spread is at 0%. Then to spread the effect out further from the edges, increase the size value. The more you increase it, the wider the glow appears. I'll drag my dialog box down a bit so we can see more of the text. Now at this point, the effect doesn't look much like spray paint. For one thing, our glow needs to look more like an outline around the shapes of the letters. To fix that, click on the small arrow next to the contour preview thumbnail. And then choose the cone contour by double-clicking on its thumbnail. It's the one in the top row, second from the left. And right away, we see a much stronger effect. But it still doesn't look like an outline. Even though our text is transparent, the glow only appears around the outside of the letters. We need it to appear inside the letters as well. To fix that, uncheck the Layer Knocks Out Drop Shadow option. And now the outline appears both outside and inside the text. You may need to go back and readjust the size value to change the thickness of the outline. I'll set mine to around 120 pixels. And finally, add some noise to the outline by increasing the noise value. A value of between 25 and 30% should work. And this adds little speckles in the outline, making it look more like spray paint. At this point, we're done with the initial effect. So now, let's learn how to blend the effect in with the background, so it looks like the text is actually spray painted onto the background and not just sitting in front of it. Still in the Layer Style dialog box, select the Blending Options category on the left. I'll drag my dialog box up higher so we can better see what's going on. Down at the bottom of the dialog box are two sets of sliders. The top one says This Layer, and the one below it says Underlying Layer. To blend the text in with the background, we need the bottom one. Click on the black slider below the left of the gradient bar and begin dragging it towards the right. As you drag, keep an eye on your text and you'll see the darkest areas of the background starting to show through it. But the problem is that the transitions between the text and the background are very harsh. To create smoother transitions, press and hold your Alt key or the Option key on a Mac. Then click on one side of the slider and drag it away from the other side. The slider splits into two halves. You can then drag each half independently to control the transition between the text and the background. The left half sets the brightness level where the text begins to appear in front of the background, and the right half sets the brightness where the text is completely visible. The space between the two halves is the transition area where the text and the background are blending together. Adjust each half until you're happy with the effect. In my case, I'll set my left half to a brightness level of 10 and my right half to a brightness of 60. Again, I'll drag my dialog box out of the way. And now we see a much more realistic spray paint effect. We're done with the main effect, so click OK to close the Layer Style dialog box. In the Layers panel, we see our drop shadow listed as an effect below the type layer. And we see a blending options icon telling us that we also have some blending options applied to the text. At this point, adding more text is easy. All we need to do is duplicate our type layer by dragging it down onto the Add New Layer icon at the bottom of the Layers panel. A copy of the type layer appears above the original, complete with our drop shadow effect and our blending options. To reposition the text, select the Move tool from the toolbar. And then with the Text Copy layer selected, I'll click in the document and drag the text upward. I'll also hold my Shift key as I drag to make it easier to drag straight up. To move the original text, I'll select the original type layer in the Layers panel, and then I'll click and drag the text downward. Now, since our text is still just regular type, we can edit the text without losing the spray paint effect. Let's say I want to edit the text at the top. To do that, I'll double-click on its type layer in the Layers panel. Double-clicking on a type layer both highlights the text and automatically selects the Type tool in the toolbar. Then I'll change the word from Paint to Spray. To accept it, I'll click the check mark in the Options bar. The new text is a bit too wide, so I'll resize it by going up to the Edit menu and choosing Free Transform. Then I'll drag one of the corner handles inward. I'll also hold my Alt key or the Option key on a Mac to resize the text from its center. I'll drag the text up a bit, and then to accept it, I'll click the check mark. And finally, to change the color of the paint, double-click on the drop shadow effect below the type layer. Then in the Layer Style dialog box, click the Color Swatch and choose a new color from the Color Picker. I'll choose a bright yellow by setting the hue value to 55 degrees and the saturation value to 100%. I'll leave the brightness at 100% as well. I'll click OK to close the Color Picker, and then I'll click OK to close the Layer Style dialog box. To change the color of the bottom text, I'll double-click on its drop shadow effect, and then I'll click on the color swatch. This time, I'll choose more of a reddish pink by setting the hue value to 306 degrees and the saturation again to 100%. I'll click OK to close the color picker, and then I'll click OK to close the layer style dialog box. And there we have it. That's how to create a simple spray paint text effect in Photoshop. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Visit my website, PhotoshopEssentials.com, where you'll find hundreds of Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from PhotoshopEssentials.com.